Hello. Hey, Visby. How you doing? Teletech, how you doing? Hey, Sava. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. Does this have animations on it, I wonder? Sorry, I'm starting late today. I don't know how it got so late so fast. But yeah, so the plan was to try and make the halfling tonight. Make the low poly version anyway. We got this beautifully crafted high poly, but for some reason people complained that it was too round, not chunky enough. So let me find the I could use this. I'll just cut it in half. Yeah, I think I'll give it a go. Great if I could just do it without having to get rid of the skirt, but I think I'm just gonna make it being easier if I just got rid of the skirt, I think. See how far just screwing with the The human will get me. Oh my goodness. Halfling done. Where's that t-shirt that says ship it? He's wearing jammies. Job well done. So easy. Can take any time at all. Oh boy, he quick sauna. Looks a little goofy right now. This is worse than the gnome. It's just like his chubby kid, chubby little child. This one where it just like expands it. This under select. What is it? It's probably like select grow or something. I just have a hotkey for it. I don't know. I don't know what it's actually under. But it's like grow selection or something, so you probably find it. Have to look it up. Change this. Hey, John. Halfling dipped in paint. It's the only way to go, man. So this is. This is what we're trying to do, right? And this is what we're going for. Let's move this over there. I don't know if these guys will be in the right spot or anything, but... It's just kind of a general... Ship it right to my nightmares. Yeah, I don't know how it got so late in the day today. Like, I looked down and it was like 4:30 or 5:30 or something like that. And I thought like it's like I had just had lunch or something. So it's weird. Oh shit, I'm connected. Time flies. Time does fly when you're making lizard men. He's saying, what up, dude? It's creepy baby night tonight on the stream. I should open up the ticket as well. First, what up? Should load in like an actual texture for this. Most up to date. This is not the most up to date, but is this accurate enough? I ask myself. Hey, Chinity. Justin Beard. The two stomach faces. Should use that. Yeah, I'm gonna have to add another loop. Actually, I can use this one, I guess. looks very goofy. Skunk just sprayed near the house. Good times. Might have to do the head differently or something. We'll see. Hey, Strange Jay. That halfling has been doing far too many crunches. I could put the gnome texture on there instead. This one has less abs. Making everybody uncomfortable. If you put like a set on, don't think I have like one of this one, I guess. Bloom. Bloomy. What up? Halfling needs to do less crunches, more squats. He's got no booty at all. Oh, you're right. He's got like an indent. That's unfortunate for him. Poor guy. Skips ass day. Okay, are we doing arsenals? What? We're doing the halfling right now. Tempting to anyway. I mean, I guess I'll grab this, but it's... Oops. Assuming cool with the belt line being higher than this, so I'm gonna leave it there. Just think we had a convo about that. That's about right, right? Got a pointy butt. Should bring that one in, maybe. This one out. A little bit of a rounded thing. It a little bit. It's got some cake on him. Halflings do love cake. It's got a little bit of a muffin top there. Thank you. I myself skipped the combo or the comb over one really short hair. Well, I guess this little indent kind of works for it too. Trying to decide if I want to do this or not. That's fine. Okay. Cool. Oh man. But it's not. What's this doing over there? What is this? I need to move this whole thing over a bit too. I need to, first of all, save that. want to bring in the human again. Let's, I need to rename this too. What's the acronym for half? Half? Halfling? $7,000 zook bucks. Getting close to that $10,000. Oh. Board this again. Oh, this one. Let's do this. That guy there. Halfling needs a belly slider. I have bad news. Okay. So now I should be able to relax this a bit. That handsome little gentleman. Got a butter face, but it's okay. To the back. Ta-da. But instead of a belly slider, but instead of belly, the slider says number of cookies. Do you find working with the low poly models to be more challenging? It can be in some ways, because I have only so many edges, like getting this sort of curve, getting like a rounded chubby little boy. My initial instinct was to add another edge, but you know, if I just place this one kind of in the right spot, it works. Worried about this shoulder though. Oh, and I've already mirrored stuff. Stuff's not aligned. I can kind of do some relaxing in the middle, but the edges should at least be lined up on this. So it, it's in the, you know, the region that it needs to be in. Probably the same with this guy, huh? I thought we wanted the belt that high. That's why I put it that high. We had a conversation about it, but I can move it down. In the concept, it's lower. But I thought you mentioned at one point, like, they would have it, like, kind of in the middle. I can move it down. Like that. And I can put another one here and make him even fatter. Is that the right spot? I need to get the, Oh yeah, I don't even have the... Wait a minute. Let's undo that real quick. This is the belt line. But for the halfling mate, male, I think a thick belt and a low overhang belly. Well, I'm gonna give him a little like pudge like this, but I'm not gonna do any sort of overhanging thing. But yeah, I'm just trying to get like the. It's got kind of a. Bit there. Trying to get the right kind of location for this. I think the belt is technically on the skirt, which I got rid of, so this would be where it's at. So where do we want this? This is the question, I guess. Oh dear. All right, I'll keep it here. Although I think I want this like that. It's kind of round. What happened to his your butt, man? I'd get all weird. Got a weird butt somehow. Don't know what happened. Everything else is fine, right? Is that neck too long? It's got a long neck. Halflings don't skip like neck day. Okay, so I guess that's everything. I just need to do the skirt now. There will be many rework rounds. Everybody's got thoughts on Halfling. Relaxing here or not. Shoulders a little wonky, but the shoulders are probably always going to be a little wonky. What the heck? Quit moving. What is this? I got so many things now. Well, that's fine. Yeah, good thing we got a lot of padding on the textures, and the stuff that we're actually putting in, at least I'm putting way more padding as well, so should be good. More padding equals good. I thought I'd put out the chainmail with all the skin and everything on it, but I can't find anything else. The plumpness of the torso turned out looking nice right above the belt. I hope so. It's hard to kind of get a feel for feel for it with like the textures that are on there, you know. These are not the correct textures. If it's obvious or not, but these aren't the right textures for this. Yeah, that belt's ready to blow, isn't it? Okay, I guess I gotta stop procrastinating and just do the skirt. Oh. Snap to you and save myself 50%. Oh, we got some more biological facts. It's been a while. Biological fact. Halflings can expand their bellies, causing their belt to whip out for 1d4 damage. I didn't know that. Wondering if that leg bend is too bendy. The buttons on their shirt also act as projectiles and do 1d4 damage. Each point of d4 is a button making contact. Oh. It's like a built-in damage shield or something. Are these feet too small? Need to go. Is this what the people want? Hey, Durgith. We're making the halfling right now. Kind of made the halfling right now. Kind of missed the whole thing. New player races. One step closer to dwarves. You're not wrong. The halflings are kind of the required intermediate step to, in order to do the dwarves and the gnomes. Even though technically we already have the gnome. He doesn't have his own rig, I don't think. And that's kind of the thing we're waiting on, or we need to suss out. Gnome ring is a spit. Uh-oh. We got a happy halfling here. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Tuck that bad boy right back in there. Calm down, buddy. He saw a cookie or something. Saw some jum-jum. Thank you. Goblins de-scoped. We're cooking. For a third dwarf race. Put a little halfling away, pal. Family show. Vergoth, I think I'm going to have to fight you. Very unfairly, too. Ideally, with when you are asleep or drunk. Okay, should we gotta go over to Gnome Fights. Gnome Fights channel and have each other represented as one of the gnomes. Okay. This is that. This one is that. Playing this. And I need to load the guide. I need the belt be here. Thadvek, good evening, sir. You watch GDQ at all? I do not. So I don't know what that acronym means, stands for. Game's gone quick. Nope, never heard of that. Game's done quick. No, not familiar. Sounds like a speed running thing. So there's the belt. It's very clearly labeled. Til ilt. Til ilt. Then you got the shirt here. It's the shirt. I'm gonna stroke, read that. Okay. Blink twice if you're okay, Zukin. You guys can't see me blinking. I'm not okay. Easier to do. This halfling already looks dope as hell. He is a multicolored little boy, yes. Yeah, like being able to, since we've gotten the human sorted out, we got the UVs sorted out, we got, you know, the built-in skirt and just how we need it to be, it should be fairly easy to take him and kind of squish him and pull him to fit the other guys now. So I just need to, it helps me to do like a little sculpt, and then I can just kind of shrink wrap to that in Blender, and then we have our little boys and girls all sorted. Look at that. Reminds me of the VW Harlequin Gold in the mid-90s. Racers got separated. I mean, racers are, we haven't gone through and kind of like sorted out the bracers on the texture side yet. Just cause, just haven't spent the time. They were kind of like part of the gloves for a while because we didn't have bracer functionality for a little while, but it's in now, so we can do that, but just haven't done it yet. Oh shit. That the this guy needs a stern talking to. These guys need to stay where they are. Look at that little gentleman. Golf, not gold. Who's taller, halflings or gnomes? Halflings are taller. All your transformations are gone. The stream points. Yeah, I think a lot of my stream things are like based on my camera, which I kind of haven't been using for a while, so. Two textures there. I got rid of all the faces, I think. Oh, we got that one. There we go. Oh yeah. Turn off wireframe. How's that for a halfling? Ugh. Save that. I'm going to. Try and find the gnome ears. Open. They've got pointy ears, right? Okay. I think we're probably gonna end up doing like when we get some textures for these guys. I might be able to chunkify the ears and even add some verts to the nose too. Yeah, I was thinking about I'm trying to like figure out what the nose is supposed to really look like. And chunkify chunking things up doesn't refer to making them fatter. It means it's technically referring to making things lower poly. I think that's the original thing, but yeah, we could I could try and like. I mean, let's see. Like that. Just get rid of that screaming music. Boom, done. Sort of. Need to clean this up. Is it? It's actually not. I need to check for N-guns as well. I'm loving the way this is shaping up, by the way. Looking great. I see a fling druid in my future. Halfling druid, I assume, is short for. Okay, boom, kill that. And then, so quick pro tip here for all you guys. That are into Blender, you can duplicate stuff, and you know it basically just copies it, but they're separate. So anything I do, you know, if I make this bigger, the original one doesn't change, but you can do a copy special, which I'm not sure where it actually is. Duplicate objects, duplicate link, yeah. So duplicate objects is just the normal duplicate, but duplicate linked, it duplicates it, but it links them together. So you can, if you edit one, it'll change the other. So that's what I just did to get the ear sorted out, because I didn't want to like have to move it back. So I just did a special duplication, and then I put the duplicated one over on this, and then made the changes, and this one got changed too. And now I can just mirror this back. And we've got our little halfling boy. And you can actually, you can also, you can just link stuff too. Like if you just had two separate things, you can, like, so these ones are not controlled, they're not connected, but I can link them, link object data. And then now they're linked together as well. It's just a way to like connect stuff together. It comes in handy here and there. It's a nice little trick. Oh, we got a little Enigon here. Tragic. I'm not thrilled about this edge flow here, but I don't really know what else to do with it. Just have that, I guess. Halfling is slang for halfling in Blood Bowl. Maybe it isn't more widely used. Yeah, I've never heard of it. The only other like shorthand for halfling I've heard of is like assling, which is a derogatory and you shouldn't use it. Shame on you. I imagine halfling is also a bit of a derogatory thing. I don't know why like halflings get shit on. I totally understand dwarves and gnomes, but halflings, they didn't do nothing. They're sitting at home eating their cake, man. Don't make no sense. Just don't make no sense. Okay. So we got ears. And the nose was the other thing, which I'm wondering, still wondering about. Do this because it looks like it looks to me as though the nose just kind of shoots out from the face. So if I were to try and do that. Why didn't it? There you go. Look at his little nose there. Is this kind of what you were thinking, Goblin? Is this my in the right direction here? Little button nose kind of thing. More button than pointy. Like more round, because that's just more edges, which, yeah, we are limited on. I can add more, but why do they get more? It's not fair to everyone else. It's got pointy noses. Also becoming difficult to maybe it could be done with just a box. Maybe not even need to bevel. I was referring back to when it was a single point. Oh, okay. Okay, I'll go back to... We'll go back then, because this one works. Because this works for the model. Probably needs to be a little bigger though, right? It's kind of weird, honestly. Like that. Of course, the texture is not helping. She's not helping out a bro here. Halflings are all about excess. I could just be rotated if like a just a regular cube like that works, which actually that may work better, honestly. I just need to okay. Fox nose, haha. I assume with the point out though, right? That works. Unfortunately, All good. All nice and tidy. It's like Frodo in the Mithril. I kind of like it as square, not a diamond when you rotated it, but I don't know how that will mess with shit. I'm totally being halfling next playtest, no pressure. Yeah, let's see how much trouble that would be, because I need. Like, I basically need to, because I need the up and I need the one down the middle, because everything has to be cut in half, and then I need this one to connect these ones. So I basically just need to add the corners and then make it a box that way. So it's just kind of adding edges, really. Oh, that's really big. How did it get so big? It would just be easier to keep it like this, honestly. I think that works. I mean, because it's just adding a bunch of edges. Well, hang on, let me see. I could just redo the whole face structure.
Quick question, when was the last time you hit save?
Oh man, it's been a while, probably, huh? I'll save it without the notes. I also have this, which I can get rid of. Probably should have saved it before I, before I got rid of the nose, huh? On ocean steed, my words gain wings. Also, all in speed I forth will bring. For noble deeds thine honor sing. The brave man slain Valkyria waits. Reward for strain to Valhall take. As long as we never have to move the face. We have a little square nose. Oop. you guys know, the guy who did the music for Spyro the Dragon was, he was in the band The Police, Sting. He was the drummer. That's why the Spyro music is the best ever. Hey, look at that, he's got some chubby cheeks. That works. Stuart Copeland is the drummer of Police. Yeah, he did Spyro, set the Spyro music. Like all the, what we're listening to right now. Oh, look at that, his little nostrils are on the little thing, that's funny. Yeah, anyway, that needs to be, Okay, let's put, skin. Let's try that one. Half male body. Half male ears. Apply those. Actually, let's undo that. Every time I hear the Spyro music, like just the original stuff, it's good, man. It's just fucking good. Maybe it's nostalgia, though. I don't know. I mean, it's good regardless, but. Okay, ears done. Body done. Head needs to be merged back. Is there an edge there? I don't think it likes this. Gonna add some supporting edges there just to help it out. We definitely need ones there too. So we had this issue with the female face. We didn't have any We didn't have enough supporting edges around the eyes, and all the faces that we painted looked like they were like squinting, and we were like, "What the hell's going on here? I don't know what's going on." And it was because we didn't have the quad that was here, like without this edge, it was too large and it was too warped. So some of the programs like 3D coat and, well, it wasn't, I think 3D coat, it was fine, but in Blender and in Unity, it was like warping the texture on it. So, we have to add some more edges there. Head is done. Let's attach it to the body. Let's merge to the neck. And then we'll put the legs back on. And let's merge those again. Okay, so now we got our little halfling. He's got his skirt. Oh shit, I didn't do the cloak either. I need to do the cloak. Let's save that. It was saved here. We're at 9 o'clock already though. So I might just kind of call it for the night and pick it up tomorrow, and then I can roll into doing the female version as well, because I told Shifty I was going to do the female first, and then I totally forgot to do the female first, and here we are. So she's gonna yell at me. Yeah, she's not gonna yell at me. I hope not, anyway. But yeah, this dude's good to go. I just need to add the cloak, because the cloak is built into the base model. The problem though is we need to wait for Erkenstaff to do the rigging and stuff. So, I mean, I could try and like throw it in, but it's gonna look bad. I can totally do it, but yeah, we'll have to replace it as soon as we can. Yeah, so we also need to do the skin color, the skin textures and stuff, so they don't look horrific. And then need to figure out some hair. But yeah, still a lot of work to do, but I think just getting the models kind of sorted out first of all is good. It's a good momentum. And it's just cool. Just cool. So yeah. It'll be interesting seeing halflings in robes. People are not gonna be prepared for that. Okay, so yeah, that's good to go. Look at him in his little Inquisitor set. He's a little Inquisitor boy. It was awesome watching another race coming together. Yeah. Yeah, I don't have, like, if I had... So the armor sets are kind of like broken up into like different layers and stuff, so I don't have them kind of ready to go to throw on like in their entirety. I should maybe it'd be worthwhile to just make some stuff. Like here's the fighter set. I should actually probably do that so that I can like kind of troubleshoot issues. I think this belt is not in the right place. That's not where the belt is. I would like this to load the right texture, please. Why is this so different? Oh, it. Oh, okay. It only goes half. I thought this went all the way down the hand. That's why. We're okay. We're good. This. Needs to come in now. Have to kind of stretch the UVs here. These are the shin guards, they go up to the knee, and then knee needs to come down. I have my little rainbow thing. Okay, hey Goblin, if you want to start it up, I can raid. Cause I'm about to head off anyway. Just kind of doing some final little bits and bobs here. Halfling, it looks pretty good. I think we'll definitely be messing with stuff, I think, as we are adding features and stuff, because I think the shape of the head and stuff, I'm kind of unsure, but it's hard to get a grasp really without like a good texture or something. So, but yeah, we'll sort it out though. Well, this is like version one. We'll do some texture work, and then we'll probably do some edits as well from there. But yeah, guys, that's it for me tonight. Here's my thing. We'll go to end credits here, and I'll raid Goblin when he fires up his thing. And for those of you who want to stick around and watch more stuff, we've got that. And for you guys heading off to bed, thanks for hanging out. It's cool. Yeah, it's been a while since we made like something kind of brand new. We've been spending a lot of time kind of fixing up stuff that we have, or just kind of reorganizing things and that sort of thing. So I was a little bit nervous. A little rusty feeling, but we did it. It wasn't too bad. Yeah, so. I don't know if, okay. There we go. All right, guys. Thanks again.